Welcome to Live Online and happy Easter. He is risen. I just love Easter. I love what it symbolizes. I love the story of how Jesus died on the cross and endured all this suffering for us so that we wouldn't have to. And then he rose again 3 days later, defeating death, sin, and the enemy. I love how death no longer has the final say, but Jesus does. It's such an exciting day. I just love Easter. And I hope you guys are doing well. We really miss you. Me and Ben are not together this morning, and it's because we were a little bit stupid when we were pre-recording services for lockdown. We didn't quite think that Easter fell into that. So this is why we're in separate places this morning. Anyway, I'm actually kind of relieved that I'm not with Ben, because I just can't deal with the puns. Like, it's torture, honestly. So quite happy to be in the comfort of my own home this morning. It's great. I'm kidding. I love Ben. I love Ben. I love Ben.
I love Ben.
We thought this morning that we would start by doing a jump jam. We have a song that's coming up, so why don't you grab your parents, grab your siblings, put on your best jump jam outfit and come dance with us. Let's have a good time. Start Easter Sunday out strong.
A story of grace. We have an anthem of hope. We have a reason to praise. We are redeemed and restored. You are the great liberator. You ransomed us from our shame. Now by the blood of the Savior.
Ben has started doing this thing where he interviews kids from Passion Kids and just asks some questions about, you know, life and their thoughts about God. And we just thought we'd put that in here this morning because there are some nuggets of gold in there, and I think our intermediates would really benefit from it. So why don't you take a look?
Yeah. Keep picking that nose, mate. Wait, pick it once more.
Okay.
Oh yeah, did you get it?
No.
Oh, that's all good. You win some, you lose some. Sammy, I just wanted to firstly say I love you, mate. How you doing?
Good.
That's good. How old are you now?
I'm still the same age.
Thought we'd start with a little game. Does that sound good?
Yeah.
Okay, so this game's called Finish the Lyrics. So I'm going to sing a song and you finish the lyrics, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so you ready for this? Everything is awesome. Everything is cool when you're part of the team. Everything is awesome.
And we're living out a dream.
Oh, you're good. Okay, you give me a song.
I think it's somewhere.
Is it the key? You're looking for the key of the song.
I'm not.
Like, does that help?
Oh, yes, that helps.
Okay. Go for it then. Sing me a song.
I got the feeling inside my bones. Electric in the bone. I got the sunshine
in my pocket. Got that good song in my beat. Got that. Was that good?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Thanks. Oh, well, I'm glad we got that. That was a good game. Did you like that game?
Yeah.
Thanks, Sammy. What has been your favourite part of being...
Don't let it go.
Wait, hold on. We've finished the game, mate. This is why...
Yeah.
What's been your favourite part of lockdown, being with your family?
I'm just glad that the stuff that I don't like was...
Like what?
The shoe shop.
The shoe shop. That's a tongue twister, yeah. Isn't it? Why don't you like the shoe shop?
Because it's like boring. Like you don't have any toys to look at.
Well,
nothing about shoes. And mum won't probably let me buy shoes, so there's no point of anything.
Oh, that's so true. But I choose you as my friend. Get it? Choose you? Yeah, that was a joke.
Yeah,
that was a good one. Do you know why we're celebrating Easter next week?
Because Jesus died.
That is so true. Yeah, amen.
He forgave our sins.
That's so right. He forgave our sins. And have you ever done anything wrong before?
Oh my gosh. Sometimes I ask mum this question and I think it's true, but it's not. It's like, who made God? Like, how did the...
That is a very good question. Do you know, I like to explain it like, you know how there's a painting and the painter does the painting?
Yeah.
But you don't ask the painter who painted you. Do you?
Yeah.
Like, and so it's like God's the creator, but no one created God. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it's like so weird.
It is.
Like nobody created God.
No.
How did he get created?
It's just crazy. Isn't that cool that God's just that good though, eh?
Oh no, like he doesn't even he couldn't have made himself because he wouldn't have hands. He wasn't born.
Okay, do you want to do one last thing together?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to do a rhyme and you've got to finish off the rhyme, okay? Whatever comes to your head. I'll rhyme it. So it goes, yo, Sammy, he's my friend. He is there.
For my friend, maybe.
Yeah, that works. I mean, you kind of rhyme the same words, but that's fine. Okay, here's another one. Are you ready? Yo, Sammy does not want to shop for shoes because otherwise he'll have to...
poop.
I knew that was coming. That is so good. Yo, Sammy, I love you. And what do you want to say?
Bye to you.
Bro, love you so much. Thank you for chatting. Do you know the verse that we've been learning in Passion Kids?
No. I haven't even seen it.
Good honesty.
Kia ora Live Intermediate. This is a talk I did for Easter Camp Watch Party, but we want you guys to join in because you're the coolest.
Yeah? How you going? That's so good. I actually can't hear you. This is a camera. But I hope you're doing so well. Praying for you in this time. I am married to the most beautiful girl in the whole world, and I just thought, what better time to announce some crazy news. So in September, my wife and I will be getting a kitten, and we are so excited about it. I love today because we are remembering that Jesus has risen from the grave, that he not only died for us, but now he lives for us. In fact, I couldn't say it better than my friend William Wairua, because Jesus did the mahi, and now we get the treats. There he is. I love the story in Luke 24. The women are walking towards the tomb and they are going to wrap up Jesus' body in ointment and they are ready for the funeral. And little do they know that Jesus has risen. They meet these two angels there and the angels say, "Why do you seek the living among the dead?" Of course, they see Jesus later and, well, Jesus really knows how to put the fun in his own funeral, doesn't he? But I love this line, "Why do you seek the living among the dead?" So many of us, we are living in fear. So many of us are living in discouragement. So many of us are questioning our lives. But I want to tell you, Jesus carries the scars that prove your worth. And we need to go from a place in our lives of being in the grave to a place of living in his grace. And it all starts with changing our mindset, changing our attitude, that instead of looking in fear, looking on ourselves, we look in faith to him. Instead of looking in discouragement, we look to the one who encourages us. That where the enemy is trying to send letters of discouragement and shame and hate, we no longer live in that place of death anymore. He's sending it to the wrong address. And so that's my first point. The second point is that Jesus wants the rescued to then become the rescuers. That Jesus is so clever that when he fills us with his love, we can't help but share that good news, just like he first shared it to the woman. And do you know the devil made the biggest mistake of all when he chose to kill the Son of God? Because in doing so, Jesus raised to life and brought up with him all the sons and daughters of God and raised up an army. And God wants to use us to be able to share that good news. I was going through McDonald's the other day because I'm loving it. And as I was going through, I had this thought pop into my head to get an extra cheeseburger. Now, when I hear Jesus speak to me, it's not like,
"Luke, I am your father."
But it's just this little nudge in my heart, and I get to choose whether I listen to it and step out a little bit more of my comfort zone or just retreat. And so I chose, what the heck, I'll just buy it. So as I bought it, I drove out of McDonald's and I just said to myself, "Lord, you show me who you want me to give it to." As I drove out, across the road was this massive guy with tattoos over his arm, holding a basketball, and I felt Jesus say in my heart, "That's the one." And I thought, oh heck, he's gonna eat me. And I didn't know what to do, but I chose to be able to step out. And so I pulled my car over, got out with the cheeseburger, and I was like, what in the world do I say to him? Like, "Jesus loves you," or anything like that. I walked up to him and I was thinking he was gonna throw a patty. I pulled out the cheeseburger and I said, "Hey, bro, just wanted to tell you that that Jesus loves you. Here's a cheeseburger." And his eyes just widened. He said, "Bro, you do not know what this means to me." And I said, "No, I don't, it's just a cheeseburger." And he said, "Do you know, this week I've never thought about God in my life. In fact, I thought I was an atheist. But just this week, my dad died and I've just been looking up things about heaven and hell. And I said to God last night, God, if you're real, you need to give me a sign. And bro, you're my sign." And I thought, oh heck. And so I said, "Well, do you know, I want you to know that Jesus loves you, that he not only died on the cross for you, but he wants to come into your heart." And I felt that there was back pain. And so I said, "Do you have back pain?" And he said,
bro, I do.
And I said, well, can I just pray for that? And we prayed for his back right there. And I said, how does it feel? And he said,
bro, it's all gone. It's completely healed.
And I said, your back's gone? And he said, no, the pain's gone. And it was completely healed. And we started to chat. And right there and then I said, Jesus wants to come into your heart. Would you let him? And he said, bro, I want to give everything for Jesus. And so we prayed together. We became Facebook official friends. And then I went off and thought nothing much of it after that. And then later on, he called me that day. And I answered the call and I knew it was him because he said,
bro!
And I said, hey, bro, what's happening? And he said, bro, you'll never believe it. I didn't tell you at this time, but I've been addicted since I was 11 years old to drugs and to smoking and to all these different things. And ever since you talked to me, I haven't had a single craving for those addictions. We got together that week. He came to church. Something happened inside his heart where he just started weeping and knowing of the love of Jesus. And his whole life changed from there. He started to tell his family, and his family gave their lives to Jesus. And he found purpose. And I want to tell you that not only do we become rescued in that time, but we start to show the love of Jesus and rescue others, because the Father longs for every person to come to know him. And the last thing is to know that we no longer live in a place for, but from. We no longer live for victory, we live from victory. We no longer live for acceptance, we live from acceptance. We no longer live for God's love. We live from God's love, because God loves us so much. And when we receive that love, we are no longer striving for these things, because Jesus has his arms wide open, just as he did on the cross, to say, I accept you as you are, as you come to me. And now let me bring healing and bring life. Wherever you are, whatever you've done, no matter what your life is at right now, Jesus is no longer wanting you to live in the dead, but to know that he is the resurrected king and he is resurrecting you. He wants to bring life to you afresh. Do you know that in the midst of this time, some of us think, well, if I just do good stuff, will that be enough? I was at the supermarket the other day and I had a whole lot of groceries. We didn't buy toilet paper though, because I'm on a roll with that one. But as we got there, my card declined. It was about $300. And I thought to myself, maybe I should just try and bargain with the checkout chick. And so I said, I'm a good person. And I thought maybe I'll do puppy dog eyes or something, like something doesn't look very nice anyway. And the person said, sorry, the price has to be paid. And someone came from behind me and said, I'll pay for him. And he buzzed his card and I was paid for. And do you know it's the same what Jesus has done for us? That he has paid the price so that we could be free. That when we turn from the wrong things and turn to him, he gives us new life. And even right now, I believe that he is bringing healing over people. He is bringing hope to people. And he is the God that won't let you go. If you would love to receive Jesus in your heart, you can just say this prayer. Heavenly Father, I thank you that you love me. Thank you that you sent your son to die on the cross for me. I'm sorry for the wrong things, but I turn from them and I turn to you. I open my heart to you. Thank you that I'm your child. And help me to love others the way you love me. In Jesus' name, amen. Guys, welcome to the family. We'll know that Jesus is with you in this time, and he is using you to not only change your world, but the world around you as well. Elbows for Jesus. Love you heaps.
Happy Easter.
Ya Grace Vineyard. Let's remember this Easter that we live in victory. Help me out, boss.
John 3:16 said God loves us, so he gave his only son, that whoever will believe in him won't die, but that those who believe Jesus have eternal life. Jesus died to show the worth of you and I. For in 3 days he rose again, take it all out, sit in shame. We are free to dance again. We live forever.
Let me tell you what to sing. Now we live in victory. All glory to our King. We're children of the living God. So let's dance, dance, dance. Tell the world of all he's done and all of his plans, plans, plans. The kingdom of God is wherever we stand, stand, stand.
That's right.
And everybody's welcome. So let's start dancing. Woo! Sing hallelujah. And let's dance,
dance, dance.
Sing hallelujah. Let's dance,
dance, dance. share God's love with everybody. I'll share God's love with everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll share God's love with everybody.
Come on, spread the love.
Share
the
God's love. I'll share God's love with everybody.
This Easter, may God's love fill your home as you stay at home. That rhymed. Oh, wait, no, it didn't.
Hey, guys, we would love to hear from you if you chose to follow Jesus today. Know that it's the best decision that you will ever make, that from today on your life is going to be radically different because you've chosen to run after him and alongside him. Me and Ben are so stoked for your journey and all that Jesus will do in and through you. And we would love to hear from you if you decided to do that today. Ways that you can connect is you can email us. You can email ben.mcgregor@grace.org.nz. You can email me at sophie.scott@grace.org.nz. Or you can message us on our Live Intermediates Facebook page or Instagram page, and we will get back to you. We'd love to hear from you. Guys, so I just thought that I'd give us some practical tips this morning.
It's practical tips with Sophie.
On how we can go deeper with Jesus. You know, if you have friends and you never spend time with them, then you'll never actually get to really know who they are. And from experience, friends who usually don't have time for you probably aren't the best people for you. And we can't really be good friends of Jesus if we never intentionally set aside time for him. And so I have one main practical tip today, is that in order to grow deeper with Jesus, we need to spend quiet time with him. And I have five practical tips on how we can do this. Tip number one is just sit in your room in silence. I think there's something really beautiful about this. It might feel a little bit weird at first, but just sit and ask Jesus to come, and you'll usually just feel this peace and invite his Holy Spirit to come and fill you. That's one of the ways we can connect with Jesus and get familiar with who he is. The second one, tip number two, worship in your room, worship on your own, put on some music and dance and sing. Maybe you play an instrument. Why don't you whip it out and just sing to Jesus, worship Jesus on your own time. There's something so beautiful that happens when we do that. Tip number three is to read your Bible. We learn so much of who God is through his word. There's a reason we have the Bible in it, so that we get to know him and see how he moved in the lives of other people too, because we're all humans. We can relate to so many things in the Bible, and sometimes he can really speak to us through a verse or story. And so I'd encourage you, if you're wanting to go deeper with Jesus, pick up your Bible, have a read. There's so many good books in there. Tip number four is to pray. Prayer is our direct line to heaven. It's how we connect with our Father. We can bring everything to him, our worries, our anxieties. We can tell him happy stuff that's happened during our day. I talk to Jesus a lot. I pray a lot. I feel like I'm constantly in dialogue with Jesus. I just tell him everything. And one of the ways we get to know more of who he is when we talk to him. And usually when we pray, he actually speaks back to us. And it's usually not in an audible voice. I've never heard the audible voice of God, although some people have. But that's usually not quite common. But sometimes when I pray, God deposits little thoughts in my mind, and I just know it's from him, and that's how I speak to him and have conversation with him. The last tip, tip number five, is to go on Jesus dates. Do your favorite things with him, because he's the one who placed those passions in your heart, and so you can partner with him in that and just ask him to come when you're doing your favorite things, because he placed it in you, so of course he's going to love doing those things with you. Jesus is constantly pursuing us. He's constantly wanting to go deeper with us, and all we have to do is say yes and partner with him in that. He's constantly outstretching his hand, and he's just waiting for us to grab onto it. I'm just gonna pray for us to finish, so why don't, wherever you are, just put out your hands, maybe close your eyes, and just posture your hearts to receive. Father God, I just thank you for who you are. I thank you for the beauty of Easter. You're just so stunning, Jesus. What you endured for us so that we could live freely in your presence, so that we wouldn't have to bear the sin and the shame that we deserve to. Thank you for taking that on yourself, Father. We just love you, Jesus, and I ask that you would come and fill the homes and hearts of these wonderful intermediates who are watching, Jesus. I ask that you would draw near to them in this time, that this would be a season where they would grow deeper with you and have a deeper understanding of who you are, that they would know your love for them in ways they never have before. Thank you for who you are, Jesus. We just love you. I pray that you would bless these families who are watching, Father. We love you, Jesus. Amen. Guys, thank you so much for tuning into Live Online this week. We hope that you have the best Easter Sunday with your family. Celebrate well, because Jesus is alive and he loves you. We miss you guys and we cannot wait to see your faces soon. Have the best week. Bye.
Yo, Live Intermediates, we thought we'd end with a dance party. Who's ready to rock?
Shekels, Buzzy Baker.
All right, here we go. One, two. Oh wait, what's the tempo?
One, two.
Here we go now.
To the shackles on my feet, so I can dance. I just want to praise you. I just want to praise you. Every chain that would keep you bound, oh. And every light that would hold you down, yeah. And every single wound that you're carrying now. Great, Jesus come, so Jesus come. Cause by the blood of the Lamb, I was born and then and free. You were blind, but now you see. So the shackles ain't gonna conquer me. In him is victory. To the shackles on my feet, so I can dance. I just wanna praise ya. I just wanna praise ya. Yeah, you broke the chains, now I can't lift my hands. Now I'm gonna praise ya. Let's sing it again, everybody. Took the shackles now. Took the shackles on my feet so I can dance. I just wanna praise ya. I just wanna praise ya. Broke the chains, now I can't lift my hands. Now I'm gonna praise ya. Yeah, I'm gonna praise ya. Right, so come on everybody, listen up, cause he's calling you. So rise up, gonna fight the shame, fight the pain, be the change through the power of Jesus' name. And I said we won't stop, no, 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 not until the day that every chain will drop and every soul wakes up in his love. So let us be a generation of his love.
Through the fire and the rain, filling every kind of way, God has broken every chain. Let me praise.
Shackles on my feet, so I can dance. I just don't wanna play. You broke the chains, now I can't lift my hands. Now I'm gonna praise you. Yeah, I'm gonna praise you. Come on. All right, sing this out.
When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David danced.
Yes, like David did.
When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David danced. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David danced.
To the shack.
To the shackles on my feet so I can dance. I just wanna praise you. I just wanna praise you. Broke the chains, now I can lift my hands. Now I'm gonna praise you.
Come on!
Everybody jump at the same time. Here we go.
Boom.
guys, great job. We're done.